We're continuing our conversation with the Knox County Health Department about Webidemic, their effort to combat online health misinformation. You know, we all read stuff online and we think that we have whatever illness they're talking about. Every month they focus on a different theme, the health department does, and in November they'll be talking about the personal health stories we read online and how they can affect our decision making. So here with us is Dr. Martha Buchanan, director of the Knox County Health Department. Thanks so much for being with us. Some of these stories can be really powerful and we think, oh, those are exactly the symptoms I have. Wrong.
It can be, yeah. Yeah. Absolutely. You know, we often hear stories from friends and family, and when I was in practice, I heard stories from patients about, oh, what happened to my friend who took that pill or got that test or, you know, went on that diet, something horrible and scary. And so they can be powerful. Mm-hmm. Really powerful, and we don't need to use them to make medical decisions with them.
But you guys are saying it doesn't mean you don't necessarily need to read them. It's okay to read them, just don't let them impact.
Absolutely. You know, realize
sanity.
right. Realize the power they have and what they are. And, you know, read them, take them into account, talk to your doctor about them. That's fine. But don't use them as a basis for making decisions for your family and your own personal health.
Does this lead to a challenge, though, for you as a doctor when someone comes in because you're the one making the diagnosis? That's got to be tough.
Sure, it can be really challenging. And and again, we'll go back to how powerful those stories are. They're a great way for us to connect with one another. And, you know, your aunt says, oh, honey, I know just what you have and all of that. And maybe she has some knowledge and you need to listen to her. But again, have that conversation with your provider and look at the evidence to support whatever they're saying.
What's the first thing you should do, you know, if you do have symptoms? Because right now in this day and age, the first thing we do is we do go online. What do you recommend,
Dr. Google?
Yes, exactly.
So I think the first thing you should do, it's fine to go online, it's fine to talk to your friends, it's fine to look at that information. But one thing you want to do is make sure you're getting the information from a credible source. So that's something the Webidemic Toolkit can help you with. But then also, you know, there's no substitute for conversation with your healthcare provider. Your healthcare is personal, and they know about your health and they know about the medicines you take, and you need to have that conversation with your healthcare provider.
So folks watching at home and they're thinking, oh boy, I'm guilty of this, don't worry, we all are. How do you get the toolkit?
It's on our website, Knox County Health Department website. You can look at it and read through it. We hope it's something helpful for folks to use to be able to look at information and go, maybe I should ask about this or
Very
get a
good.
Little more information.
All right, doctor, always good to see you.
Thank you
so much.